Hello everyone, myself Ms. Shailaja Dyawarkonda, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's lecture, we are going to study modes of transportation. In this lecture, we will study in detail about the road transportation. The learning outcomes of this video, at the end of this video, the viewers will able to explain importance of road transport. The viewers will able to explain the classification of road transport by IRC and waterborne macadam road. Importance of road transport. Roads plays a very important role in the transportation of goods and passenger for short and medium distances. By the means of all the transportation, road transportation is cheaper and easy to the transportation system. It is comparatively easy and cheap to construct and maintain the roads. Road transport is easy to access hilly areas. It's easy to carry goods to hill areas by the roads. Road transport system established easy connect between farms, fields, factories and markets and provides door-to-door service. Road transport operating cost is cheaper than rail transport. As I told, the road transport is easy and cheaper than other transportation systems, that is road, railways, waterways, airways. The construction and maintenance of the road transport is also easy by the means of other transportation systems. Now, classification of routes. These roads are classified by IRC. IRC stands for the Indian Road Congress, which is established in 1934. So these roads are classified as express highways, national highways, state highways, major district roads, other district roads and village roads. Now, so in this lecture we will study about the classification of roads. Now, it is the typical cross section of the road. Here in this road cross section we can see the road land width, roadway, carriageway, shoulders, bumps. So in further we will see these all terms in details. So right of way. Right of way means it is the actual land which is occupied for the road construction. Means if you see in this figure, land width, which is nothing but the right of way, means it is the total area occupied by the construction of road. Road margin. Road margin means it is the margin from the road boundary or the building line. So road margin is, if you see here it is building line, again it is road boundary. Road margin is the distance between road boundary and the roadway width. Roadway width, it is the embankment of or bottom width of the highway cutting. Roadway width means, if you see here, from the road margin to the next road margin, it is called as roadway width. It may be in embankment or it may be in cutting. Embankment means whenever original ground level is there, you have to fill or you have to increase the height of road construction. So you have to fill some other materials. It is called as embankment. And cutting means you have to construct the road below the original ground level. So these are the some standard land widths are given by the IRC, that is Indian Road Congress. For national highway or state highway, normal width is 45 and the normal range is 30 to 60 meter. And in mountainous areas, it is 24 meter. So these all dimensions are in meters. For major district roads, normally it is 25 meters and the range should be 25 to 30 meter. And in mountainous areas, it is 18. Likewise, the other district roads and village roads are also classified. So these are the standard values of the roadway width of the roads given by IRC. So you can observe here national highways, which are single lane and two ways, and major district roads and other district roads which are having single lane or two lanes. So it is the normal roadway width of the roads as provided. Here village roads mostly are in single lane, so it is provided as 7.5 meter. Carriageway, shoulders and side slope. Carriageway means it is the actual part of the road which will comes contact in the traffic, means the uppermost part of the road surface is called as carriageway. Shoulders, the portion of the roadway between the outer edge of the pavement and the edge of the top surface of the embankment. If you see here, in this here, this is the shoulder part, means it is the distance from the road margin to the upper surface of the embankment, so it is called as the shoulder. Then side slope, these side slopes to given to the sides of earthwork of a road in embankment or in cutting for the stability. So it is the standard width given by the IRC for the carriageway, means it is the actual width of the road surface. For single lane it is 3.75 meter, for double lane it is 7 meter, for two lane it is 7.5 meter and intermediate carriageway it is 5.5 meter and for multi lane pavements it is 3.5 meter. Berm, the portion of the land which left in between toe of the road embankment and the inner edge of side drain is called as berms. Spoil bank, these banks are constructed from surplus excavated earth on the side of the road cutting parallel to the alignment are known as spoil banks. The boundaries between the pavement and the shoulders are or the footpath are known as curbs. Formation level, the reduced level of the finished surface of the earth is known as formation level. If you see in this figure, the distance between the side slope and the side drains, it is called as berm, means it is nothing but the divider between the road and the road margin and the embankment of the roads. These slide slopes are provided for the stability of this embedded material, and this side drains are provided to drain off the surface water from the roads. And next is formation width, it is the lowest width of the road, means it is lower part of the embankment which is called as formation level. So these are the common elements of the roads. Now it is the typical cross section of the expressway. So here they have provided cycle tracks, footpaths, three lane one way pavement. So again lighting provisions. So normally the lane width is 10.5, it is three lane one way width, means it is provided in three lanes pavement. It is the typical cross sectional of the national highway. As we see, the national highway and the state highways are normally of same carriageway width. So here it is the typical cross section of national highway and state width. So here you can observe the shoulders, pavement width, longitudinal drains. Drains are provided for each and every road cross section to drain off the surface water from the road surface. So here it is carriageway is formation width is 12 meter and the carriageway width is 7.5 meter. Means the actual surface of the road which will comes contact with the vehicles, it is 7.5 meter. So these widths are provided as per the IRC, that is Indian Road Congress. So it is the typical cross section of the village road. The national highways or express highways normally built up with the roads which are concrete pavements or flexible pavements. It is the typical cross section of the village road. In village road, we will use the normal natural materials like soil, murum, etc. So here it is subgrade in trench, but it is necessary to provide the shoulders and drains in village road also. Drains are provided to drain off the surface water, means whatever surface water collected. So already we are using the natural material like soil, sand or murum. So we have to easily drain out the water from the surface of this road. Waterborne macadam road, which is called as WBM road. The WBM road consists of clean crushed aggregates, mechanical interlocked by rolling and bonding together with screening, binding material and water lane on subgrade. This type of roads normally we will see in village areas. So it will having the layers of stones, the layer of filtered material and pavement surface. As I told, in village roads we have to use the natural soil, the natural material like soil, sand or murum. So WBM is nothing but the road which is made from the natural materials. Means if you see, the lowest part is of layer of stones which are interlocking with each other by mechanical. The next layer is layer of filler material. Means in filler material you can use the small size of aggregate or the sand and or murum, and the uppermost most part is the pavement surface. Again here also we have provided the shoulder, so it is called as WBM roads. So these are the typical images or cross sections of the WBM road. The lower part is of rocks which are interlocking with each other, then above part is of filler materials and the upper part is of pavement, that is small sized murum or soil. Now pause this video and try to answer these questions. Here these are the answers for the questions. These are the references considered for the further study. Thank you.